Welcome, lovelies. Here we are, the long-awaited second house tour. Lots has been done, and even though it might not show to you, we know that the basics are in place, and now it's only building up from there and adding on. So I'm starting outside, because what has happened outside is we replaced the walkway from the sidewalk and the steps up to our house. They were pretty crumbly and not very nice looking. Plus, the top step was very high. It makes a difference, you know, the distance of the steps, the width of the steps. So this still needs to be replaced, but we're going to have a little meeting with our neighbors and see if they would like us to be in compliance with their railing, or if we can do our own thing. We like a little bit more ornate, not too much, but we'll see. So the other thing while we're outside is we, Glenn and I, worked 4 weekends and we redid all the windows. And you might say, what, 4 weekends? Well, a few hours on Saturday, a few hours on Sunday. But it is an enormous amount of work because everything was changed. Like the mechanisms were oiled, the cords were taken out, they're double hung windows, the cords were taken out, new cords put in. Everything was very rough, like neglected for, I don't know, many, many years. So we had to scrape, putty, sand, prime, paint. So you can well imagine, and all the little paints had to be. So Glenn did all the mechanisms and the scraping, and then I did the painting. So we really enjoyed it, put some music on, and of course the reward is fantastic. They look amazing. And yeah, we're very, very pleased. We replaced some broken panes and some cracked. We have a wonderful glass place here that cuts the size that you need for your pane from antique, from old windows. So you don't get a little pane with a brand spanking new shiny window, because it's the difference. The older ones have all the little specks and wobblies in it. So yeah, we're very pleased with it. So now the front is done, which was our aim, and now we can take our time on, there are still quite a few other windows on the side, in the back, but we can take our time with that. So a little bit of a story about the front door. It's not the original. This is a much lighter door than they would use in the olden days. This is just a piece of plywood. So this was a glass insert, and it probably broke or whatever happened to it, and they put a piece of plywood inside. We had a guy here that specializes in restoring older doors, and he said it can be done, you know, but it's all pretty light. And we feel a front door is, it's your first thing you see. So I found a store in Toronto. It's called the Antique Selfridge. I have to look it up to tell you exactly the right name. Anyway, it's in Toronto. I perused the website. They've got many, many beautiful used doors. So we're going, when we're in Toronto around New Year's, we're going there and we're going to pick out a door. Very exciting, I hope, because they need to have the right size, right? Let's go inside, and I'm very excited to show you what we have been up to. Come on. So, lovelies, the last time, the first time I showed you, I think it was just a bare skeleton. We have now, everything has been reinforced. All the beams have been reinforced. We have framing on all the walls. The electric, the plumbing, the HVAC, the heating is in. And we are now waiting for inspection from the city to go on. Then we can, we're going to blow in insulation. And then we can do drywall, and then the walls can go up. So. The main thing is that it's all done and we can close it up for the winter, so that all the trades can work during the winter. And you know, that was our aim. So this is just for you who didn't see the first video. This is our living room. Fireplace not working, but we are going to see if we can, we have a few different options. We can do, of course, a gas insert. or electric little fireplace. We were in the Netherlands and we saw a little wood burning fireplace with a chimney going, a new chimney going outside. So we're looking into that because Glenn is really serious about having a wood fireplace. He likes it. I like it too. This is the dining room. And what we did is we put in a new window. This is going to be the dining room and Glenn's office. So we were going to use this space a lot. And we had this window made. It's a replica of all the windows in our house. And they did a fantastic job. You can barely see that it is a new window. So we're very excited about it. And very excited about the light that it brings in. And now you can have a view of the backyard. Today was a huge day because we've been waiting for the masons to come in to close up the wall around the window. And I was driving up here and there they were. I was so happy because we need to tap. It needs to be closed up. It's going to be cold. The snow will be flying. So this is a huge step in our plans. We are going to leave this open. This is going to be open dining room, living room situation. There's a beautiful fireplace behind these boards. We're going to put an insert here, a gas insert. Let me show you the hallway. We are going to keep this all open. This is from where you come in. You will see this whole hallway down to the end wall, which we inserted with a window wall. You will see in a minute when we come closer. I just wanted you to see the feel of how we have imagined and designed this whole plan. So, of course, the stairs going up, we will go up in a minute. And then this cutest little powder room. I absolutely love it. I'm going to make it like a little showpiece. I don't know what yet, but I think I'm going to get some wild wallpaper. And other than that, I have really not thought about paint or paint colors or kitchen cabinets. I'm being asked all the time, but I haven't. We've had so many other things to deal with. Like for instance, the electricity, the electrical. Where do you need your outlets? It's very important. We had to really put our mind to that. The other thing is that our baseboards that came out of this house, that we all took out, denailed, not us, but our tradesmen, they denailed and it's stored, so we hope to put them back in. But so the electrical outlets had to be above the boards because I didn't like them inside the wood, you know, damaged wood. So that those all those little kind of little things, you need an electrical outlet there for here and for there and for here and there. So all those things, it took a lot of planning. So once everything is like the walls are up, I think I can really put my mind to decorating and colors and kitchen cupboards. Then the fun is really going to start. Okay, follow me. So this is one wall of pantries. This is the heating ducts, of course, and the HVAC. This is going to be a whole closet, pantry for the dining room that is close by, right? Then we're going to step into this part, which is the kitchen part. So again, for you lovelies who weren't in on the first one, this house was built in 1830. And this part was the first part that was built. This was the first house. 1830, the front part was built in 1880, not really sure. And you can really tell the difference. This is like a very simple, I call it a little Mennonite house, very simple lower ceilings, and this one is more Victorian, high ceilings, much more luxuriously built. We're going to make the kitchen here. We've got it all laid out. This is going to be the work area. We're going to get a new kitchen door with more glass because we need as much light as we can in this house, because it's a semi, so you always have one wall that's closed without any windows. You see all these windows we are going to refurbish, and they're going to be beautiful. So we're going to have a little deck here built to the side of the house where the barbecue will be, a little table maybe where we can eat, and definitely a few bird feeders so we can watch from the kitchen. Going to have a little dining room, just a little one for four people. And I can picture us eating breakfast here and looking out the window and looking at the birds. It's going to be gone. This is the staircase to the basement. This we built for safety so people wouldn't fall in it. But it will be a trapdoor. Actually, it's a design from Glenn. I'm really looking forward to it. With a trolley on the ceiling. And so it's going to be a little industrial look. But this will be this. So this will be all floor space, right? And this will be my home. So I have a little bit of a dividing wall. I like that. I didn't want it all open. And I'm going to put plants on it and stuff. I'm going to be doing some sewing, some yoga. I have my own TV, my music, and these two beautiful windows, of course, which are overlooking all kinds of greenery. And then this is the piece de resistance, the big window. The middle window is still to come, and that is with the screen door in it. And as you can see, we're going to look out over the entire garden, which is like a rimbu. It's like a wilderness right now, but I am really looking forward to making it fantastic, fabulous. We also put electrical in the corner there because I want a pond there so that we can sit on this patio here. This is going to be quite a large patio, and we can overlook the pond, and then you can also see the pond from the window in the dining room. Lots of excitement. I feel it's really coming together. We had our trusted worker Ron work in the basement. First we thought it's a good sized basement, and then there's a huge crawl space. First we thought we're just going to clean it up and leave it, but he painted all the walls white, cleaned it up. We've got the electrician put in lots of lights, and now Clem is going to use it as his little workshop. So we are utilizing every ounce of space in this gorgeous house, and actually it becomes bigger and bigger. We've got so much space in here, but we will fill it with lots of grandchildren and animals and all kinds of stuff. Okay, let's go upstairs. So lovely, this is the upstairs. I love this little corner here. The morning sun is coming in this way, and then it goes around to the backyard, and lots of light comes in here. Don't know yet what I'm going to do. Probably sitting to read corner or something. I don't know yet. Hopefully we can keep this brick wall here, take the plaster off and make it a whole brick wall. We have to see what the masons say, if it's in good shape. I love brick walls here and there, little pieces. So this is the master bedroom. So as you can see, we're still having to finish off quite just a few little things in the windows. But I am just thrilled the way it all turned out. We have a bathroom here. We have a walk-in closet. It's huge. I never had a walk-in closet in my entire life. And when I was a little girl, I had to share a little closet with three sisters. So I still can't imagine we did it, but hey, you didn't know anything different, right? So it was all fine. So this is like pure luxury for me. Okay, and then we go around, and we have laundry here. I love laundry in the upstairs by your bedrooms. Because let's face it, that's where most of your laundry is, right? Your sheets, your clothing, everything. Some shelving here for maybe linen and laundry, detergent, what have you. And then we go in here, and this is the guest room. And lovely, a closet for their particulars. A bathroom. In our bathroom, we just have a shower and two sinks, vanity with two sinks, toilet, of course. And I am adamant to have a bathtub because I love baths. And we're going to put it right in here. Shower will be in the bathtub, of course. And then a toilet sink. So small, but just perfect. The other thing that I really wanted was a heated bathroom floor. Tessa has it, and when I'm at her house, I absolutely love it. It's just wonderful. So that's coming in our bathroom, not in the guest room. Quite a lot of exciting things. Now, you think this is finished. No, there's a whole other part to this house. And let's go, I'll show you. I love all these little steps and these little nookies. And so, what I showed you downstairs, the back part, that was the original house, the kitchen and my home. Well, that was their living room and kitchen, and this was their sleeping quarters. And when we bought it, there was a very rough bathroom here. We cleaned it out, and we have a roughed-in bathroom. So we're not going to finish it. It's just for resale. If people want to buy it later, they can just make a nice bathroom here. All this, of course, will be finished with drywall, and windows will be finished. This is going to be where we will store our storm windows. We have storm windows coming that we are putting in on the inside. So when spring comes, we don't have to hire anybody to take them off. We can take them off ourselves, clean them, and store them here. I love that idea. So this slanted ceiling, I love it. We are going, this is of course quite dark, so we have three skylights coming. 1, 2, 3. And they will bring in a lot of light here. This was a staircase going down to the kitchen. As you can imagine, that was their staircase for the house, the original house. So we took the staircase out, was not necessary, and now we have this floor space too. That is the window to the garden. Glenn is debating, he might put all his printing, copying and stuff here, and make it a little bit of an office too, because we don't want the whole dining room cluttered with office stuff. And now I am going to show you the attic, which is a fabulous attic, and my grandchildren have all been here to see it, of course, and they cannot wait to play hide and go seek in this house. And I can so understand it, because the sky's the limit. All right, this is the spooky attic. The side floors were taken out and going to be replaced. Then, of course, this is all going to be wall space. That one has the return of the HVAC and the heating, so that one we cannot use for that, but that's okay. We've got lots of storage. So I have to show you one amazing, exciting thing, and that is this window. This was an unbelievable, this was so crappy and so old, and I cannot believe what a beautiful job they did. They made this whole new window as a replica to the old one, and it's just, I'm in love with it. So I've decided to put my yoga mat here and make like a little corner with my little Buddha and my meditation corner, because this, I just love this. And look at the view we have of our lovely neighbor's tree. It's absolutely gorgeous. The finished home will have two bedrooms, right? The master and the spare bedroom. But once this one is finished, I'm going to put a bed here. So whenever we have more than two people, they can sleep here and use the bathroom in the guest room. So if the house has to come up for sale, it will have four bedrooms. It will have the two on the second floor. It will have the attic, and then the room that I showed you with the skylights. So if a big family wants to buy it, they can. Okay, lovely. So I think we are at the top of the house, and we are at the end of the tour. Thank you for watching, and ask me any questions if you like. Definitely we'll do an update if there's anything to show you that we think is of excitement to you. And I am pleased with all your excitement about it and your interest. Thank you for watching.